Welcome to Basics of Information Technology, Part 2. In this video, we will cover storage devices like hard disk, CD-ROM, DVD, pen drive, memory stick, input-output devices like keyboard, mouse, monitor, printer, scanner, webcam. First is hard disk. A hard disk or hard disk drive is a non-volatile data storage device. It means whenever power is switched off, data will not be erased. It is usually installed internally in a CPU, attached directly to the disk control of your computer's motherboard. It contains one or more platters housed inside an air seal casing. Data is written to the platters using a magnetic head which moves rapidly over them as they spin. See in this diagram, we have a platter here and this platter rotates like this, and this is your read-write head. It moves like this. Data is read from or written to this hard disk. Now we have CD-ROM, compact disk read-only memory. So it means you can read only data inside this CD. You cannot write. A CD-ROM is an optical disk. Optical means light is used to read data from this CD. That contains audio or software data whose memory is read-only. It is the device used to read CD-ROM drive. You might have seen a drive in your laptop on right hand side. So that drive is also known as optical drive, which we put a CD or a DVD to read them. CD-ROM drives have speeds ranging from 1x to 72x. It reads the CD roughly 72 times faster than 1x per second. Next we have DVD. DVD or digital versatile disk. It is also an optical disk storage medium, but with enhanced data storage as well as higher quality of video and audio formats can be stored in DVD as compared to CD. It is widely used for video formats, audio formats, as well as software and files. Now, USB pen drive, also known as flash drive. Everybody knows what is a pen drive. It is a small storage device shaped like a pen, that is why it is called pen drive, with built-in data storage that connects to a computer by a USB port. So all these spaces where we insert pen drive are known as ports. It comes in variety of sizes like 4GB, 8GB, 16GB, etc. Next we have memory sticks. As you can see this figure, all these sticks are used in cameras, mobile, etc. These are known as memory sticks. These are used especially for portable devices like camera, in a form that can easily be removed for access by a person. Now we have input devices. The first is keyboard. A keyboard is a peripheral device that enables a user to input text into a computer or any other electronic machine. It is the most basic way for the user to communicate with the computer. There are various types of keys, as you can see this diagram. This is your escape key. These are function keys, F1 to F12. This is enter, backspace, delete, print screen. This is used to copy the whole screen, just like screenshot in mobiles. Scroll buttons, indicators, this is number pad, arrow keys, controls, window key, alt key, space bar, control, shift, capital letters. So the keys include punctuation, alphanumeric, and special keys like the window keys, function keys, and various multiplayer keys which has specific functions. Now we have mouse. If you see, there looks like a mouse with a tail. So this is a cable which is connected to a port, a PS2 port or USB port. This is a wheel. This is a button for left click. This is a button for right click. So a computer mouse is an input device that is used with a computer. Moving a mouse along a flat surface can move the cursor to different items on the screen. Items can be moved or selected by pressing the mouse button. Besides moving the pointer, a mouse can be used to execute computer commands using mouse gestures. I am also moving this pointer using the mouse. The common mouse gestures include point, click, right click, double click, drag, right drag, rotate wheel, and press wheel. Next is monitor. A computer monitor is an output device that displays information in pictorial form. Images or text are generated by graphics or video adapter, which is inside your CPU. There are different types of monitors. CRT. You must learn all these full forms. CRT, cathode ray tube monitors. These are bulky monitors just like television. Then LCD, liquid crystal display monitor. TFT, thin film transfer monitor. LED, light emitting diodes monitors just like LED TVs. Then we have touch screen monitors, plasma screen monitors, OLED monitors, and so on. Printer. So we have varieties of printers. See figure on the right hand side. Different types of printers, pen printers, non-pen printers. About these we will see later. So printers are output devices used to prepare permanent output devices on paper. So first, impact printers. Impact means physical contact. So in this type of printer, hammers or pins strike against a ribbon and paper to print the text, just like old typewriters. This mechanism is known as electromechanical mechanism. Now we have scanner. A scanner is an input device that scans documents such as photographs and pages of text. When a document is scanned, it is converted into a digital format. This creates an electronic version of the document that can be viewed and edited on a computer. For example, in our school's office, there is a combination of printer and scanner. You might have seen on the table. And this is your barcode reader. These are normally used in reading barcodes on items in malls. Now we have a webcam. It is a video camera that feeds or streams an image or video in real time to or through a computer to a computer network such as internet. Webcams are typically small cameras that sit on a desk attached to a user monitor or are built into hardware. For example, in laptops also we have a webcam. So, all these topics are covered. Now, tip of the day is revise, revise, revise. Once you go through all these topics, read them again. If you have any doubt, write in the comments. And thanks for watching.